Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example of how to convert polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates. And the polar coordinates that we're given in this problem are 2, comma, negative pi over 4. So the formulas that we're going to use to convert these polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates are the following. X equals r cosine of theta and y equals r sine of theta. We're going to use these two formulas to take these polar coordinates here and convert them into Cartesian form. Or rectangular form, same thing. So we are going to first recognize that our polar coordinates are in the form r, comma, theta. Normally with rectangular or Cartesian coordinates, your coordinates are x, comma, y. Well, when you're talking about polar coordinates, the x coordinate is r and the y coordinate is theta. R being the distance that you go out from the origin, theta being the angle from the x-axis. So anyway, 2 is r and negative pi over 4 is theta, which means we're going to plug those in to our two formulas here for r and theta. So the x equation, or the equation we're going to get here to find our x-coordinate, plugging in 2 for r and negative pi over 4 for theta gives us 2 cosine of negative pi over 4. Similarly, when we plug those same two numbers in to our equation for y, we'll get y equals 2 sine of negative pi over 4. So that is how we set up our two equations to find our rectangular coordinates. To evaluate cosine of negative pi over 4 and sine of negative pi over 4, we're going to need to use our unit circle. So you could go about this two ways. You could either take the angle negative pi over 4 and start at the angle 0 on the unit circle and work backwards an angle of negative pi over 4, or you could convert this negative pi over 4 to a positive angle. And the way that you would do that, remember that the entire angle around the unit circle, 360 degrees in other words, is 2 pi. So if you say 2 pi and then you subtract negative pi over 4, or I should say you add negative pi over 4, you'll end up with a positive angle. So when you find the lowest common denominator here, you're multiplying 2 pi by 4 over 4. So you get 8 pi over 4 minus pi over 4. And when you simplify that, you get 7 pi over 4. So in other words, what this tells you is that negative pi over 4 is the same angle as 7 pi over 4. It's going to be the same angle on the unit circle, and you can evaluate either way. So let's go ahead and jump over to our unit circle here. You can see that here is the angle 7 pi over 4, right? So we converted our negative pi over 4, and we found 7 pi over 4. So you can evaluate here. But if you didn't want to go through the process of converting your angle, you could start from the angle 0 right here and move, instead of normally we would move counterclockwise this way around the unit circle. This time, since it's a negative angle, we would move clockwise around the unit circle until we came to negative pi over 4. In this case, you can see the denominator of this first angle here is a 6, and then the denominator is a 4, and then a 3. Since we have negative pi over 4, and 4 is our denominator, you're looking for the first angle with a denominator of 4, which is this angle right here. And in other words, you're going negative 1/4 pi around the unit circle. So that's going to land you right here at 7 pi over 4. Notice that if you added 7 pi over 4 and pi over 4, you would get 8 pi over 4, which would give you 2 pi and land you right back here. So negative pi over 4 is the same thing here as 7 pi over 4. But either way, we're looking for both cosine of this angle and sine of this angle. Remember that when you're looking at the unit circle, cosine of an angle means that you're looking at the x-coordinate, positive, square root of 2 over 2. Sine of an angle means you're looking at the y-coordinate, which in this case is negative square root of 2 over 2. So let's head back over here to our equations. You can see that we have cosine of negative pi over 4. We already found that cosine of that angle is positive square root of 2 over 2. With the y equation, sine of negative pi over 4, the y coordinate at negative pi over 4 or 7 pi over 4 was negative square root of 2 over 2. So we plug those in for cosine of negative pi over 4 and sine of negative pi over 4. And when we simplify these, we'll get the 2 in the numerator to cancel with this 2 in the denominator. And our x coordinate is going to be square root of 2. Same with y here, we get the 2 in the numerator and denominator to cancel, and we're left with negative square root of 2. So when we put these two together, this x and y coordinate, our final answer is square root of 2 comma negative square root of 2, which is exactly equivalent in rectangular or Cartesian coordinates to our polar coordinate of 2 comma negative pi over 4. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!